This is a diffusion model in Excel and a random walk model. Also, we can call it Brownian motion because, you know, Brownian motion is the random movement of the molecules of a liquid observed through a microscope. So this model has, the workbook has four worksheets. The first one is a random walk restrained to a lattice. Essentially, if we hit reset, you see the particle is, we have one particle whose trajectory we are going to monitor. So this particle is now near the origin, very close to the origin. We can adjust the step size. And as we see, as we hit start pause, the particle will start moving around, and it is a time process. Every time step, the particle has four choices. It can move up, down, right or left, and it will move in any direction with equal probability. So if we model this for many steps and model it many, many times, we will get a spread with a centroid in the origin. We can adjust the step size here. Let's say, let's make it smaller. And you can see the particle is still going around. Let's stop this. Go to the next worksheet. This is a random walk free motion, which means the particle this time will be able to start near the origin, but while moving a constant step, adjustable of course, it will move with equal probability in any direction between 0 to 360 degrees. Let's reset this and start it, and we can see the particle moving around. This is also called the drunk man animation. Essentially, if a man is extremely drunk, it will move incoherently, and every step will be uncorrelated to the previous one. So that's what happens here. Stop this. The third model is a lattice constrained diffusion. It is essentially the first model, but we have 10,000 particles, and we can reset it. They all go into the origin. And start the model. You can zoom in or zoom out, and we can see they're roaming around and spreading. We can of course adjust the step size, and here is a radial density function. It shows how many particles are constrained within a certain radius positionally. So now we can say change the step size, say to 2.7, and you can see all this lattice constraint was destroyed. Let's stop this. The last worksheet contains another diffusion, but a free diffusion in the sense that just like in the second model, the free random walk, the 10,000, any of these 10,000 molecules or particles will be able to move with one fixed step size, in this case 3.7, we can adjust it, but in any direction with equal probability, so between 0 to 360 degrees. Let's reset this and start it, and you can see the particles are dispersing. But in average, their centroid will still remain in the origin, statistically speaking. Of course, there will be displacement, but if we repeat this experiment a million times, the more we repeat it, the more the centroid will, the average of the centroids will remain in the origin. Of course, this is also tightly related to how random this random number generator is in Excel. Is okay. I mean, I've never been preoccupied with precision of random, whatever randomness, but it hasn't been so good at the beginning, but in the last years, Microsoft has improved this significantly. Let's stop this model. If you want to download this model, you can go to my site, my blog, excelunusual.com. So excelunusual.com. You will land on the home page. You can type here random. Hit return in the search box, and you get four results. Three are relevant. One is a random walk model. The other one is a tutorial to this model, and the last one is contains also the Brownian motion animation, which is the diffusion model. You can click on this one, come here, read the tutorial, and then you can see, you can view the PDF, the full tutorial, or you can download it from here. Open. I'm not gonna open because I already have it open, but it's all free, it's here. Thanks for watching.